In this video, we're going to talk about receptor ligands. So we need to talk about different types of ligands. We're going to focus on two, and then we'll see how these ligands affect the response caused by a receptor. And of course, we need to introduce a lot of terminology as we talk about these different ideas. Receptors are proteins that are involved in biological pathways. Ligands are molecules that bind to receptors, and sometimes the consequence of binding can turn on a receptor or turn off the receptor and the corresponding response. Ligands that turn on a receptor are called agonists. There are different degrees of being turned on. Some agonists fully activate a receptor. These are full agonists. Ligands that do not fully activate a receptor are called partial agonists. It is possible for some ligands to bind a receptor and prevent other ligands from turning on the receptor, so there's no response. These ligands are called antagonists. There are other types of receptor ligands, but full agonists and partial agonists and antagonists cover most drugs that target receptors. We measure the activity of a receptor ligand through graphs. The y-axis is our response, and the x-axis is the logarithm of the ligand concentration, log L. For full agonists at low concentration, the left side, the response is zero. At high concentration, the response rises to 100%. In between, we follow a sigmoidal shape. At the point of inflection, which occurs at the halfway point on the y-axis, the x-axis corresponds to something called the log EC50. The EC50 is the concentration, C, of the ligand required to get a 50% effect. The partial agonists look very similar to full agonists, except the curve does not rise all the way to 100%. It'll be some number lower. It might be much lower, just a little bit lower. These curves for partial agonists also have an inflection point, and that inflection point is still called a log EC50. So even though the y-axis value is not 50%, it's still considered 50% of what the partial agonist can do. We still call this a log EC50. For antagonists, we perform these experiments where the response starts at 100%. So we have the receptor mixed with a full agonist. As we add antagonist, the response drops again in this sigmoidal kind of shape. And what's happening is the antagonist is pushing the agonist off the receptor, and therefore the response is dropping. We again get an inflection point, and this x-axis value is called log IC50. The IC50 is an inhibitory concentration because the antagonist is inhibiting the agonist. Receptors are named after their natural ligand, or their endogenous ligand. The histamine H1 receptor naturally binds to histamine. Histamine is the endogenous ligand. 2-pyridyl ethylamine and chlorpheniramine are both exogenous ligands. These are unnatural ligands. For the histamine H1 receptor, 2-pyridyl ethylamine closely resembles histamine and is also, as a ligand, a full agonist. Chlorpheniramine is similar enough to bind, but does not cause a response and actually blocks the action of histamine. Chlorpheniramine, therefore, is an antagonist. It blocks the full agonist and yet causes no response. Both of these are competitive ligands because each binds to the receptor at the same site as the endogenous ligand. So now we've seen different types of receptor ligands, and we also know how to interpret their action based on dose response curves.